I don't know about you, but I'm grateful this morning.
Amen.
Amen, somebody. Just see, just show me a grateful way.
Yes.
God has been good to you. Just show me a grateful wave. Amen, somebody. Good to be in the house of the Lord just one more time. It's great to be home. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen, somebody. Thank God for my church family. Thank God for the leadership here that would keep things together while I was away in my doctoral studies. A week for me, Brother Sam, seemed like a month. Amen, somebody. I was down in Birmingham, Alabama, retracing the steps of the civil rights movement, watching pictures of those young men and women who have given their lives that we might have the right to vote.
Amen.
The right to have equality. And I'm grateful that that sacrifice was taken, and I'm grateful to be a part of the doctoral program under Dr. C. Anthony Hunt, which is called the Enacting Martin Luther King Beloved Community Scholars. I thank God for being here, because I could never imagine that God would orchestrate my life in such a way that he would use me as a vessel to bring forth his word. Again, I'm thankful to be home. I'm glad to see everyone, and I'm not going to be before you long, but I'm going to be strong. I want to invite your attention to a familiar passage of scripture found here in the Gospel of St. Mark, a familiar passage of scripture that we've all known, but as I was away and I was reading this text, I saw some things in this text that made me look at this text, Brother Durrell, altogether different. And so, St. Matthew's chapter 4, starting at the 35th verse, and the word of God reads, "On the same day, when evening had come, he said to them, 'Let us cross over to the other side.' Now, when they had left the multitude, they took him along in the boat as he was, and other little boats were also with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that it was already filling. But he, Jesus, was in the stern, asleep on a pillow. And they awoke him and said to him, 'Master, teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?' Then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, 'Peace, be still.' And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, 'Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?' And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, 'Who can this be that even the wind and the sea obey him?'" Amen, somebody. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
I'd like to preach for the few moments that is mine from the sermonic theme that if Jesus said it, Jesus will do it.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Father God, even right now, we know that you're God and there's no God beside you. We say thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you, God, that you didn't have to do it, but you did it. You died on Calvary that we might have a right to eternal life. Oh God, set worn down that you might be glorified and magnified. And after all is said and done, let somebody be touched, healed, set free, and delivered by your servant's words. Amen. Somebody. Brothers and sisters, many of us have heard this text over and over again. James Cleveland, he had a famous song, gospel song, that said, "Peace, be still." The gist of this text this morning is really not so much about a storm, but it's about our relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And oftentimes in our lives, storms come up.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. If you live long enough, either you're going in a storm, you're stuck in a storm, or you're coming out of a storm. But I stopped by to tell somebody this morning, whatever storm that you're going through in your life, God will see you through. God will take you to the other side. When we look at this text this morning, I believe that Jesus heard some folk crying. Jesus heard the prayers of some folk who were in a bad way. And although the disciples didn't hear the prayers, the Lord heard the prayers. And the Lord said to the disciples, let's go to the other side. And when they went to the other side, the Bible says that there are or were some little boats. You know, brothers and sisters, Sister Stimley, the text never tells us, Paula, where those little boats went. The text does not say that it was swallowed up in the storm. Did they go another way? It just says that Jesus and the disciples were in the boat and some little boats were with them. And as they got into the sea, a storm, we know, rose up. And I want to say this morning to somebody that what you don't learn on land, the Lord will teach you at sea. They were at land. They were on land first, Brother Sam. They were sitting and listening to Jesus talk about the Beatitudes. They were listening and following Jesus. And he says to them, let's go to the other side. He gives them instruction. We're going somewhere. I'm taking you all somewhere. But the wisdom that I've given you, now I want to see whether or not you can apply. So he tests them by taking them from the land to the sea. And when they get into the middle of the sea, we know that the winds and the waves and the storm rises up. Jesus is asleep in the stern of the boat on a pillow. These folk who profess to have prayer, profess to have faith, profess to be followers, now are fearful of the storm. And yet they are fishermen. They are fearful of the storm. They are not strangers to the water, but this is something unique about this storm. Fishermen might have seen the winds and the waves, but they have never encountered water filling up the boat. And in that fear, they wake up Jesus and they say, Master, do you care that we should perish? And Jesus looks at them and he does not rebuke them, but he rebukes the waves first. He says to the waves, to nature, peace be still. Then he turns around and he says to the disciples, why are you so fearful? Why do you have no faith? And I stopped by this morning to tell somebody that it's all right while we're in church and we're singing songs like Grateful, and the choir sings Wonderful this morning, and we are worshiping this morning, but It's only until we leave out of the walls of this church that we are faced with a situation that our faith, amen, is tested, and our faith must be applied. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
He said we can do all things through Christ Jesus that. Well, what happened in the middle of the sea? Jesus really is wanting us to understand that he's always with us. Mm-hmm. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but Jesus is with us during the good and the bad. And although he's asleep, he's not asleep. For the Bible tells us that he neither sleeps nor slumbers. Amen, somebody. He sleeps in the storm. Well, that should tell us something. If the Lord is asleep,
Then
we ought to be asleep.
Yeah.
If the Lord is not worried, we ought not worry. Amen, somebody. That we need to exercise our faith that Jesus is a way maker. That Jesus can do anything but fail. That we need to apply. This is what Jesus wants to show us. We need to apply the very things that we read, sing, and preach. He tells us something. He says, remember the route. Remember the itinerary. Remember the direction. He says, we are going to the other side.
Yeah.
Paul, he did not say we're going to die at sea. He says that we're going to the other side, which implies that I don't care what we're going through on the water. I'm going to get you, amen, somebody, to the other side. Now, if they were really listening to their leader, their Lord and Savior, they would know. In all of his traveling and all of his teaching, he never said he was going to die at sea. He said he was going to die on Calvary.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. Mr. Benton, that would have been enough. LaTanya, that would have been enough for them to have some kind of confidence and faith in knowing that they were going to get to the other side. But not only that, but the fact that he was with them.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
He's on the ship and he's laying on a pillow in a storm. Amen. He's not going to drown.
Right.
Nor is he going to allow us to drown.
That's right.
And what that says is that the disciples, they had strong prayer, but weak faith.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You, whatever you pray to the Lord for, you got to allow the Lord to do what he says he's going to do.
Yeah, amen.
You got to take your hands off your problem and not try to fix the problem yourself, but you got to give it to the Lord. Amen, somebody. Because he's with us. Even when we think that he's not with us, he's with us. Yes, he's with us. He's with us in our trials and in our tribulations. He's with us. He's with us in our deaths of family members and graduations of grandchildren. He's with us. He's with us unemployed and employed. He's with us. He's with us in crisis and without a crisis. The Lord is with us. The Lord is with us even right now, just not on Sunday morning, but the Lord is with us every day. We always say that if you're going to pray, why worry? And if you're going to worry, why pray? Give it to the Lord, because the Lord is going to see us through. He tells us about the route. He tells us about his closeness. And then the Bible says to us that be a rose. Be a rose. Sometimes, just sometimes, it may appear that God does not hear your prayers. sometimes, just sometimes, it may appear that situations get worse before they get better. But the Lord hears your prayer. I stopped by to tell somebody this morning that the Lord hears our prayers. And he may not come when when we want him to. But the Lord is always on time. The Lord wants us to refocus, be focused, and refocus on him. This is what this text means this morning, that he wants us to refocus on who he is, because it's evident that some folk, or not some folk, but in this case, the disciples have forgotten who he is.
Yeah.
He's Lord.
Yeah.
He's a way maker. He's a bridge over troubled water. Water when I'm thirsty. Bread when I'm hungry. He's Lord. He's all that we need when we need him. And they forgot that. Because they asked the question, who is this? Wait a minute. Who is this that could calm the winds and the waves? That's Jesus. It's your Savior. And while he was laying down, in my closing, while he was laying down, situations happened. Yes, while he was laying down, it seemed like turbulence and storms were in their lives. Mm-hmm. But the Bible says he got up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen, somebody. Amen. And when he got up, amen, somebody. When he got up, the winds and the waves began to cease. That there was some calm in their lives. The last time I remember him getting up is when the devil called himself taking them down. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. They took him to a judgment hall. They dragged him and they beat him. They took him down a road called the Via Della Rosa, walking all by himself with a cross on his back. And the devil thought that he had him. The devil thought that he had him down. They took him to Calvary and laid him on that old rugged cross where they'd bang nails in his hands and bang nails in his feet. And there he laid his head in the locks of his shoulder and he died. And the devil thought that he had him. But on the third day, he got up, he arose, and said, all power is in my hands. The text is teaching us to refocus on who the Lord is. It's not so much so about the storm, but it's more about who God is. That he's saying to us in this day, I don't care what you're going through, what heartache, what headache, what seeming impossible situation you're going through, that he is Lord, and cast your cares upon him. For the Lord will make a way. We need to refocus. The disciples, first of all, could not see in the dark of the storm. And I'm saying to us today that we who go through situations on a daily basis, one way or another, we need to be refocused on who Jesus is.
Yeah.
Because the Lord has kept you and I from hurt, harm, and danger. The Lord has blessed us in a mighty way. The Lord is protecting us. Amen. On a daily basis. We need to be refocused. And when I was thinking about when I was coming to church this morning, I was looking at the Animal Channel. And I was enamored with how penguins walk. Penguins wobble. And they have to go a long way. They have an itinerary. They have to get to the other side of Alaska. And the storms come. But I noticed that, Paula, when the penguins walk, they wobble from side to side because their vision is strained. Their eyes are on the side of their head, and they have to wobble from both sides, stop and refocus, and then take another step. They wobble, stop, refocus, and then take another step. They have to refocus every few feet to see through the storm where they're going. And I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but every now and then God does not eliminate our problems just like that, but one day at a time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sweet Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
One day at a time, you got to wobble a little bit and refocus. And you got to say to yourself, I can do all the things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me.
Yes.
You got to wobble sometimes. You got to cry sometimes. But you know that the Lord, amen, is going to bless you. You got to sometimes just refocus. It's not about you. It's not about me. It's about Jesus. I don't care what you're going through, how bad it may seem. Know that the Lord is with you every step of the way. If then, if the Lord said it, the Lord will bring it to pass. All of us have storms. All of us have situations. But if we just keep our hand in the hand of the Lord, he will get us to the other side. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you. Amen, somebody. Go in peace, and may the peace of God be with you.
Amen.
Amen. Have a wonderful week.
Yeah, you are. Amen.